In this third episode of our four-part series on Python and Django on Azure, Carlton Gibson is here to show us how to use Azure pipelines to enable continuous integration and continuous delivery of Python web apps to Azure App Service or anywhere else today on Azure Friday. Hey, friends and Pythonistas. Welcome to another episode of Azure Fridays. I'm Nina Zakarenko, a senior cloud developer advocate at Microsoft. With me is Carlton Gibson. He is a Django fellow, as well as a maintainer on Django and a lot of other packages and frameworks that you probably use. Last time we talked about deploying Python web apps to Azure App Service. Today, we're going to talk about automating deploys with Azure DevOps pipelines.
Okay, awesome. Thank you, Nina. So, the REST framework tutorial app that we've been using through the series, we've deployed it to Azure, but now we want to do that every time that we make a commit or a commit to master, perhaps. So we've integrated it with Azure Pipeline, see the build succeeded there, and I'm going to show you how that works. The first thing you've got to do is, it makes it easier, is install the Azure Pipelines GitHub app. And you can get that from the marketplace. You just search for it, it'll show up. I've already installed it, so it talks about setting up a plan, edit plan. It'll be a big install button for you. Install that, give it the permissions, and then it can access your repos. You see here it says you can build Linux, build macOS, build Windows. That's one of the really cool features of pipelines, is that you can build in across the different environments. Anyway, let's head over to the DevOps console, and here's the pipelines that I've got set up for the REST framework tutorial. And there are two here. One is CI, and then what that does is that runs the test suite. So we
what does CI stand for?
Continuous integration. The idea is that when you make a change, it runs your test suite, and if you've broken something, one of your tests will fail, and you'll notice there and then. And the idea being that the bug is quicker to fix there and then. Mm-hmm. So this is just a YAML file that you have to have the YAML file in your repo. And this is a template that you can get from the repo. You can copy it. It's perfectly generic. You can use it in yours. We're selecting a Python. I should probably update that Python version. And then it just looks for the manage.py file. It creates, it pip installs your requirements. It pip installs this for a unit, for reporting the unit test, and then it just runs manage.py test, which runs the test suite, okay? Mm-hmm. So it's a really generic YAML file. And this pipeline uses that. If I click on edit here, we can come in and we can see it, and that's where it picks it up. So it's looking for that thing. Anyway, let's go back over here. And you can see it runs the test. So we adjusted the group serializer. We had an error in that. So it does all these phases in the test, runs the tests. We can click in, we can see the results. Okay, brilliant, it ran one test. That was the test we set up for the bug we saw in the first episode. Let's close that. So that's the CI build, and that's all, that's great. But what we want to do then is deploy it, and here's where the sort of magic bit is. So we've run the test, but now we want to deploy it. And here we've got a second deploy, an app service deploy. So let me show you the YAML for that one. And that one's, again, very simple. And the key bit is just down the bottom here, where it's got this script. It says git push, and there's this complicated URL. Mm-hmm. Our current head to master, okay? And that's doing exactly what we did with the git deploy to app service in the previous video. Instead of us doing it directly from VS Code, Pipelines is going to do it from the build server.
So when we did it in VS Code, all of these variables were populated for us.
Right.
But outside of that environment, we have to take care of them ourselves.
Yeah, so here's the variables we need. We need a deployment URL, a deployment username, and a deployment password. And if you go to the environment example file that's in mm-hmm. the repo, I've shown you all about those. And you must create these for the deployment to work. If you don't if you don't create these variables, the deployment fails. You can't git push. So there's a az command to create the username and the password, and there's also another az command to get the deployment URL for your repo. And fill those in, load, and then what we need to do is tell them, if you wanted to do that locally, you'd load them into your environment and run that git command. But we need to set them in in the pipeline. So what mm-hmm. we've done here is we've created three secret variables, and these are kept in the secretly. If you unclick this folder, they disappear. You can't get them back ever again. So they're totally secret. There's the deployment password. There's the deployment username, and there's the deployment URL.
That's very secure.
Well, it's great. And then the task loads them into the environment, and then the git push command just uses those. And so it's as simple can be. The only other thing that we need to look at to see this working is the triggers. So normally, the pipelines are run every time there's a commit or every time there's a pull request. We've disabled that. We've disabled the continuous integration, and we've disabled the pull request checking. And then we've created a dependency on the CI pipeline. And what we've done is we've said when that CI pipeline passes, if it's on the master branch, then deploy.
Great.
That's it. That's how you deploy, you set up continuous deployments with DevOps as your pipelines.
That's lovely.
What else? Django filter. We have this on Django filter. So we have that set up here. And
what is Django filter?
Django filter is an add-on for Django. It's a Django app.
And you're the maintainer.
Yeah, I'm the maintainer of that. And what it does is it enables you to get rid of a lot of bootstrap when you want to take your query string parameters and use that for filtering. So you know, you'd need to create a form, you'd need to you'd need to do all sorts of things. It does it all for you, just declaratively check that out. So, but the cool thing about this is it doesn't just run the tests for one version of Django or one version of Python. Mm-hmm. It runs the test for all the versions of Python that are supported on all the versions of Django that are supported. So it's running, you know, probably 12 versions each time there's a pull request or a commit to master.
That's great.
And that's cool. It's super. And it's free for open source. So,
well, fun fact, even CPython uses Azure pipelines. In this episode, we learned how to automate with pipelines. Check the show notes for a link to the repository. It contains all the setup instructions along with the YAML files.
Yep.
On the next video, we're going to talk about developing serverless applications with Azure Functions.